there, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Regina, and in today's video, we are going to be planting and harvesting field peas. Field peas, some people call them southern peas or cowpeas, all in the same family, all kind of the same thing, all different names for the same thing. Field peas are peas that they're not sweet peas or sugar snaps that grow in cool weather. They actually are peas that grow in the heat. Now, just a heads up, my husband is currently back here with the weed whacker cleaning up the grass around my raised beds, so you'll probably hear some background noise, but that's okay, right? That has to happen, and it's so hot during the day that our times are overlapping today, and I'm perfectly fine with that. So, field peas. An example, the ones that I'm planting today are called pink eye or purple hull peas, and I'm also planting some lady cream peas. Now, these peas grow really well in the heat. They love it when it's hot, so they are a perfect thing to grow in the summer. And like many peas and beans or things in the legume family, they also fix nitrogen in the soil. So when I plant them, I'll be inoculating them as well. So black-eyed peas are a really common cowpea or field pea that pretty much everybody knows about. But if I can be honest, to me, they're literally like my least favorite in the field pea family. They're the ones that I don't grow because I don't really like them that much. But to be honest, I've never had them like from fresh. I've only had them dry or from canned. But I'm growing this year several different varieties. I'm about to plant these pink eyes and these lady cream peas. But in the bed that you can see behind me, I have some zipper cream peas growing, some white acre peas, and I believe some Sudandi cream peas as well. So lots of different varieties, and they're all delicious. Imagine a black eyed pea, but like the texture isn't gritty. It's more smooth and creamy. Delicious. And of course, in my opinion, they're best cooked with a ham hock or some other pork to give them a little bit of flavor, but they are so good. So we're gonna get these plants. I'm gonna show you guys how I do that in my garden, and it's actually really, really easy. When I planted this bed behind me, I literally just tossed the peas on the soil and then covered them up. In this bed, I'm actually gonna do trenches, little mini trenches, and then sow the seeds in there, just because that makes it easier to cover them. It was kind of a little harder than I anticipated to then go in and make sure every pea was buried when I just tossed them. So I'll bury it, plant them in little trenches, and then cover them. And let's get started. So, whenever you're planting a legume, something from the legume family, it's really good to use a soil inoculant. This makes sure that the soil has the beneficial bacteria needed for the, and y'all, I'm not a scientist, this is what I've read and what I understand, so hopefully I don't say this too wrong and sound really dumb, but it ensures that has the right, yes, has the right rhizobium leguminosarum. Wow. Anyways, make sure that the soil has the correct beneficial bacteria necessary in order for the plants to fix the nitrogen in the soil. So I always, now there may be some here already, right? But in order to make sure that it exists, you can't overuse it. But I always use this with my, when planting my legumes. Well, at least I'm using it this year. And so far, with my field peas and with my green beans on the fence, they are growing excellent. And the field peas, I did not fertilize them at all. So, and they're doing great. So I'll be using this. I'll just dump this, sprinkle this in the trench with the peas before I cover them with soil and water them in. But the great thing is that the bed where my field peas are currently, the ones that are already growing, the ones that you can actually see, the bed behind me is where I'm planting, but you can't see that one yet. But the ones that you can see in that bed is where I'm going to put my brassicas for fall. So those beans being in there is actually growing, they're creating enough nitrogen for the plants to grow, but it's also fixing nitrogen, so that soil should be really rich in nitrogen when I go to plant my brassicas in it, giving them an extra boost for the season. Now, before we get to the planting, you guys know the drill. Once you get to the point in this video where you are enjoying it, you're learning something, or you just want to give me some good vibes, click that like button. And of course, for more gardening content, click that subscribe button to subscribe to my channel. And click that notification bell so that you never miss an upload. Now, all of those things really help this video get out to more gardeners, and they also help me to grow my channel, which I would really appreciate. Now, let's get into it. So here is my bed of field peas that I planted just a little more than 2 months ago. And now I have peas that are ready to be picked. So here's what they look like. Now, it's getting dark, so I'm not going to pick a whole lot of them. I'll come back out in the morning and pick because I can't see everything that's in there, and I don't want to stumble upon anything. These are kind of thick, and my husband already killed a snake. Well, actually, he didn't have to kill it. It was dead. Found a dead snake in the yard. My husband just found a dead snake in the yard today, so I do not want to stumble across one as it's getting dark. It's actually a little bit darker than it even looks on the camera. But a few of these. So it depends on the type of pea to know when they are ripe and ready to be picked. Like these are zipper cream peas, and the way that you know that they're ripe, they start to turn a little lighter in color. They start out dark green and they get lighter in color. And also you can easily see the beans kind of bulging a little bit and they feel a little bit loose in the shell. That's when it's the perfect time to pick them. Now these are white acre or lady cream peas. I can't remember which kind, but these, they turn almost white, a really light beige color, but the same characteristics. When they feel a little bit loose, they're never gonna feel as loose as the zippers just because of the variety, but you can feel the beans clearly and they start to feel a little loose in their shells. Now this one actually let stay on a little too long. It got kind of dry. Now I can still cook and eat this. It's just already partially dried, which means it'll just take a little longer to cook. I don't like them to get this way. I prefer to cook them fresh, but this isn't all the way dry, so it'll be fine. But yeah. I'll show you, once I finish picking all these, I'll show you everything that I pick, and then I'll show you what they look like shelled, just so you can kind of get an idea of what these peas are like. But I promise you, if you grow them, if you even remotely like black-eyed peas, you're gonna like these like 10 times better. But it's getting dark, and I don't wanna stumble upon any animals doing whatever animals do after dark when I'm not out here. So, let's move this video forward. Here's what the peas look like. Here are all the ones that I picked. This is today and also into the future, the next day. See how I did that? Yeah. And then here's what they look like all shelled, because you shell the peas. They're actually pretty easy to shell. It's actually pretty therapeutic. I let my kids do it a lot. They kind of enjoy it. But here they are, shelled. And so then what I do is I cook them fresh. And like I said, I like to cook them with like a ham hock or salt pork or something that adds just that oomph of flavor. But you can cook them without that. Just kind of boil them like you would cook any other, you know, black-eyed pea. Add some onions, some garlic, some seasoning. Or what I usually do, though, I'll cook some of them fresh during the summer. And then the rest of them I blanch and then put them in freezer bags and freeze them so that I have filled peas to eat throughout the year. Actually, tonight for dinner, I made the last bag of filled peas that I had in my freezer from last season. I cooked those tonight for dinner because I knew I was going to be picking some, and it just felt really cool to me to save them and to have enough for the whole year. Now, that doesn't mean I have to eat them all the time all year, but I do kind of spread them out so that field peas are something we can have just, you know, at different points throughout the year rather than just in the summer. Thank you for sticking around to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed the content, and maybe you're considering planting some field peas yourself. It is the middle of June in North Texas, and I just planted them. So most likely, it's not too hot to plant them where you are either. It's getting dark, so I'm gonna have to head inside in a bit, but this is kind of the only time of day where it's bearable to be out here, either now or really, really early in the morning. Fortunately, it looks like my camera is showing that it's kind of light out here, which is nice. That means it's gonna look good. But before I go, don't forget to click that like button. Let me know how you feel about the video, and that also helps it get out to more gardeners. And of course, for more gardening content like this, subscribe to my channel and click the bell notification so that you never miss an update. That helps this video and this channel get out to more gardeners, and I would really appreciate that. So until we meet again, have a great one.